Hello, I'm Melvin Cardozo, and I'm responsible for verification cloud solutions at Synopsys. Today, I'm going to cover both the challenges involved in moving verification workloads to the public cloud and what Synopsys VCS offers to address those challenges. Verification makes up between 60 to 80% of the compute workload for companies today. Today, these companies run verification workloads with high utilization rates, but faster TTR and higher QR are driving them to use public clouds for both burst and sustained capacity. These requirements come with their own set of unique challenges. We can categorize the challenges into each of the layers of the traditional infrastructure architecture for verification, comprised of the user access, tools and workflows, grid software, the data and storage layer, and the compute layer. This video will focus on the challenges at the compute layer. Traditional compute infrastructure was limited to bare metal machines on-premise, statically configured on a grid into multiple queues. However, when it comes to the public cloud, compute can scale up and down dynamically using bare metal hardware, virtual machines, and containers, then come in a multitude of configurations. While this is a good thing, it presents a challenge in selecting the right kind of instance for the right kind of job. One of the primary compute challenges in moving workloads to the public cloud is the cost differential. Using on-demand instances on the public cloud is 3 to 4 times as expensive as the on-premise cost for the same set of hardware. And the cost scales linearly based on the number of cores and the amount of memory per core. Selecting the right instance type for each simulation job can present a significant cost saving, especially for simulation jobs that are mostly single process. To address this issue, VCS leverages tool insights and machine learning capabilities to optimize for the cost of verification. Based on the history of past simulation runs and insights gained during compilation, VCS is able to identify the expected CPU and memory usage for the simulation job, leading to select the right instance type on which the job can run. To mitigate the cost differential with on-premise, companies can use spot or preemptable instances on public clouds, which are typically available at 1/3 the cost of on-demand instances. These instances can reduce the cost of compute, but they also present a challenge due to the possibility of being terminated on a very short notice. VCS technology makes it cost-effective to use these low-cost instances, but also makes it easier to deploy simulation jobs on these types of instances. Depending on the size of the simulation job, VCS can be configured to do an immediate save of the simulation state when the instance is marked for termination. For large jobs that cannot be saved in 30 to 120 seconds, VCS can trigger periodic saves with low impact that result in only a small amount of the simulation being lost. In addition, VCS can automatically resubmit a job to the grid scheduler after the save is completed, so that the terminated job can be restarted on a different instance from the same save state. Yet another way to control the compute cost on public clouds is to use alternate architecture machines that have a lower cost per compute unit. As an example, the cost of ARM cores on the public clouds is cheaper compared to comparable compute using traditional x86 hardware. VCS has also been enhanced to run natively on both ARM and EPYC machines. These are just some of the efforts Synopsys is doing to help our customers use public cloud resources more cost-effectively by partnering closely with all the major public cloud vendors and data storage providers. You can learn more about Synopsys cloud initiatives at www.synopsys.com/cloud.